This poll of millennials should make you fear for the future of America. Every generation looks at the next generation and worries for the future. That Elvis Presley was shaking his hips so provocatively. Rock and roll was going to ruin the children. The parents of the hippies of the 60s surely had some legit concerns. Heck, as a child of the 80s, I might damage my eyes with all that neon. It's a line every generation uses, kids these days. But OMG kids these days. I don't know what has gotten into this generation. Most young adults go through that annoying know-it-all phase, but generally it doesn't last long, and as they age, they understand they certainly didn't know all that much. But these days we are watching a generation of sheep trying to be edgy, trying to piss off their parents, trying to make their mark. This generation is rebelling against the long-held American ideal that communism is evil. They have posters of their favorite communist dictators hanging in their bedrooms. They glamorize communism and they demonize capitalism. The problem is, they can't even define either one. When former Arkansas Governor Mike Huckabee heard about survey of America's millennials, he was able to find a bright spot, even though the survey showed vast support for communism and socialism. A shocking new survey of millennials found that half say they would rather live in a socialist or communist country than in a capitalist democracy, Huckabee wrote on his Facebook page. Well, good news, kids, thanks to capitalism, there are planes leaving the U.S. for one of those 24/7, Huckabee wrote. But tell your parents not to rent out your rooms, he added. If you aren't killed or imprisoned in your chosen communist paradise, you'll probably be moving back in with them in less than a month. Huckabee's sarcasm was matched by a serious concern voiced by Marion Smith, executive director of the Victims of Communism Memorial Foundation, after it released its report of Americans' attitudes toward socialism. One of the concerns the Victims of Communism Memorial Foundation has had since its establishment is that an emerging generation of Americans have little understanding of the collectivist system and its dark history, said Smith. The 2017 survey noted that more millennials would prefer to live in a socialist country, 44%, than in a capitalist one, 42%. The percentage of millennials who would prefer socialism to capitalism is a full 10 points higher than that of the general population. It seems that the majority of America's largest generation would prefer to live in a socialist or communism society than in a free enterprise system that respects the rule of law, private property, and limited government, the group's website stated. This is even more disconcerting when coupled with the fact that, despite millennials' enthusiasm for socialism and communism, they do not, in fact, know what those terms mean, it said. The group said vigilance is vital. Communism isn't back, it never left. We simply forgot about it. And as it rears its ugly head once more, openly and shamelessly, we seem far less prepared to meet the challenge in this century as we did in the last, it said. The survey found 26% of millennials viewed Cuba's Che Guevara as a hero, 22% said that about Russian leader Vladimir Putin the same way, and 13% said both Joseph Stalin and Kim Jong-un were heroes, according to the Daily Wire. The survey was similar to the group's initial survey in 2016 that found 57% of all Americans have a very unfavorable view of communism. However, among millennials that was at 37%, and among Generation Z, ages 16-20, the number was at 38%. That survey found massive gaps in knowledge. It reported that 32% of millennials believe more people were killed under former President George W. Bush than Stalin. Of millennials who even knew Soviet Union founder Vladimir Lenin, 25% had a favorable view of him. Millennials now make up the largest generation in America, and we're seeing some deeply worrisome trends, Smith said. Millennials are increasingly turning away from capitalism and toward socialism and even communism as a viable alternative. Smith said that there is a lot of education that needs to be done. This report clearly reveals a need for educating our youth on the dangerous implications of socialist ideals, Smith said. We will continue to work with educators to build curriculum to address this important need. Of course, Part of the problem is the liberal education this generation is given. Crazy college professors who teach with their morally superior attitude pass on their ideology to impressionable college kids who are shaping their own political views. Most college kids have no real knowledge base to question what they are being told. And for that, I blame parents. In addition to shielding kids from any hardship or pain in their childhood, most parents shield their children from news and politics as well. Whether they don't think kids will understand or just won't be interested, most people neglect to educate their kids in the political or economic realm at all. I've met so many teens and young adults who have no clue what their parents' political beliefs even are. Is it any wonder they accept what their professors say without a thought? Millennials are being exposed to one viewpoint and it is the wrong one. We need to do a better job bringing up a politically and economically literate generation. Yes, it's kinda easy to say you like communism. Move to a communist country, then you'll see. But truthfully, I find it sad that these kids are so misguided. Look at their sources of information, it's no wonder they are so screwed up. Let's not forget, these kids someday will be running the country. We better change course soon or the future is downright scary.